अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ साजिद अली। सो डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई होप यू आर फिट एंड फाइन एट योर होम्स। इन माय लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द साइमन कमीशन, एंड साइमन कमीशन वाज अपॉइंटेड बाय ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट इन इंडिया। Its major duty was to make a report for the future constitution, to make a report for the constitutional development in India. So, dear friends, it was rejected by many Indian political parties, Indian people, including Muslim League, Congress, Hindu Mahasabha, and other political parties. Because there was no anyone member who was Indian, no any Indian member in Simon Commission. There were total 7 members in Simon Commission who were Englishmen. That's why it was rejected by Indians. So dear friends, Simon Commission was appointed in 1927, but according to Chelmsford reforms, British government in India had to appoint a commission after 10 years, and Chelmsford reforms were introduced in 1919. So in this way, British government had to appoint Simon Commission after 10 years in 1929. So that period was 10 years between from 1919 to 1929. But British government in India made a commission, appointed a commission that was called Simon Commission before 2 years. Simon Commission was appointed in 1927. So we also discussed there are reasons why British government appointed it before 2 years in 1927. So dear friends, know any Indians in Simon Commission, therefore it was rejected by Indians, including Muslim League, Congress, and other political parties. In this way, Lord Birkenhead, Lord Birkenhead, who was Viceroy of Secretary of State, not Viceroy, who was Secretary of State. Lord Birkenhead was Secretary of State who challenged Indian leaders that if Indian leaders could solve Indian problems, constitutional problems, they could introduce, they could make a committee and bring constitutional reforms. So in this way, Indian leaders convene all parties conference. The major function of all parties conference was constitutional making issue. In all parties conference, it was discussed about the constitution making issue. How can we make future constitution? And how can we solve basic problems of Indian peoples, and so on. So dear friends, all parties conference was convened on 12th February 1928. In all parties conference, many political parties participated. About 100 delegates of Indian political leaders took part. They participated in all parties conference. So, dear friends, in this conference, Indians discussed about the future constitution for India, and they tried to compete British government, Simon Commission. So, dear friends, in all parties conference on 12th February 1928, subcommittee was formed. A subcommittee was formed. The major function of subcommittees, which was given by all parties conference to subcommittee, to make a report on fundamental rights, unicameral or bicameral parliament in India, position of Indian states, other political issues in India. Dear friends, fundamental rights, it means there were many communities, they were in minorities living in India except Hindus. That's why in all parties conference it was also given the function to subcommittee to make a report about the fundamental rights. And these fundamental rights were for the majority also, including minority. Unicameral and bicameral parliament. Unicameral means a single house of parliament in India, and bicameral means two houses, upper and lower house in parliament for India. So what should we do for the parliament? Subcommittee had to also make a report on unicameral and bicameral parliament with some suggestions. Position of Indian states. We also discussed in my Indo-Pakistan history lectures about the different independent states. There were 562 Indian states. They were independent. So subcommittee had also make a report over the position of Indian states. These Indian states were ruled by Maharajas, Nawabs and Rajas, different rulers. They were small rulers under the British government. They paid tax and tribute to the British government in India. They were under the supervision of British government in India. So, dear friends, subcommittee which was formed in all parties conference, it had to make reports about the position of Indian states. Other political issues in India. So, dear friends, subcommittee could not make report at an appropriate time. That's why it was decided to make a small committee headed by Motilal Nehru. A small committee. So, dear friend, the small committee was formed because first committee, subcommittee, could not make reports, could not make its works at an appropriate time. That's why it was decided in a meeting of all parties conference in second or third meeting to make a small committee to solve constitutional problems, to make reports. for the future constitution, for its reforms. So, dear friends, Simal Committee was headed by Motilal Nehru. Motilal Nehru was the father of Jawaharlal Nehru. And Jawaharlal Nehru was secretary of Simal Committee. So, dear friend, Motilal Nehru was chairman of Simal Committee to make a report, and Jawaharlal Nehru was the son of Motilal Nehru, who was secretary of this committee. Dear friends, finally they formed a report that is called Nehru Report. This is Nehru Report. Because the chairman of Simal Committee, which introduced final report of all parties conference, the chairman of this Simal Committee was Motilal Nehru. That is why it had given the name Nehru Report. So, dear friends, these are major salient features, major characteristics which were discussed, which were introduced in Nehru Report. At first, dominion status for India. According to dominion status, India had to be given independence, but under the supervision of British government. Many of the groups in all parties conference also rejected dominion status because they wanted to complete independence from British government in India. They wanted to get rid British from India. That's why they rejected dominion status. According to dominion status, India had to be given independence, but under the supervision of British government, under the supervision of Viceroy of British. So, dear friend, at first the silent feature was Nehru Report was dominion status for India. No any separate electorate for Muslims. Separate electorate was given Muslims in 1909 in the constitutional reforms which were introduced by British government, that were called Minto Morley reforms. And a separate electorate also given to Muslims and other minority communities in Chelmsford reforms in 1919 by British government. So, dear friend, separate electorate was accepted by Hindus first and last in Lucknow Pact in 1916. But according to Nehru Report, separate electorate was rejected for Muslims. No any kind of separate electorate for Muslims. It would be joint electorate. So, according to Nehru Report and according to second silent feature of Nehru Report, Muslims could not elect their representatives, Muslim representatives. So, dear friends, separate electorate was rejected by Nehru Report. Third one, constitutional reforms in NWFP and Balochistan. In NWFP and Balochistan, constitutional reforms should be brought. Constitutional reforms. In Nehru Report, it was agreed to bring constitutional reforms in NWFP and Balochistan. No one third representation for Muslims in Central Legislative Assembly. So, dear friends, Muslims demanded one third representation reserve seats in Central Legislative Assembly, but in Nehru report it was rejected because it was said in Nehru report that Muslims were one fourth majority in subcontinent. That's why they had we cannot give them one third representation in Central Legislative Assembly because their majority is small or their population is small. So, dear friends, another point, unitary system of government was opposite of federal system. In unitary system, provinces was given maximum autonomy, but in federal form of system of government, provinces were given autonomy to some extent, their limits. So, dear friends, unitary system of government in India, it would be introduced according to Nehru report. Representation in Punjab and Bengal. Muslims also demanded to elect their representatives in Punjab and Bengal according to the population. Because in Punjab and Bengal, Muslims were in majority. That's why Muslims demanded to elect their leaders, representatives, according to population, especially in Punjab and Bengal. But in Nehru report, representation in Punjab and Bengal under the population base was also rejected. Weightage formula. It was also another point. Weightage formula was accepted in Lucknow Pact by Congress and Muslim League, but in Nehru report, weightage formula was rejected. I also told you about the weightage formula in Lucknow Pact in my lecture of the Lucknow Pact. According to weightage formula, where Muslims were in majority, in that region, Muslims had to give in small seats in Central Legislative Assembly or Provincial Legislative Assembly. But where Muslims were in minority, they had to be given a large number of seats. Just like in Bombay, Odisha, Madras, Muslims were in minority, but they had been given large number of seats. And on the other hand, in Punjab and Bengal, Muslims were in majority, but they had been given small seats. So, dear friends, weightage formula was also rejected. Separation of Sindh from Bombay. British East India Company occupied Sindh in 1843 and immediately it connected Sindh with Bombay Presidency for their specific benefits. But Muslims launched movements to separate Sindh from Bombay Presidency because more than 70% population of Muslims living in Sindh. That's why they demanded the separation of Sindh from Bombay Presidency. In Nehru report, this demand was accepted. And according to Nehru report, the Sindh should be separated from Bombay Presidency. So dear friends, these are major salient features of Nehru report. Now we discuss controversies of Muslims with Hindus regarding Nehru report. In Nehru report, separation of Sindh from Bombay, separate electorate and Muslim representation in central legislative, 1/3 representatives of Muslims. These major controversies between Nehru report and Muslim League are Muslims, Indian Muslims. But these demands were not accepted by Nehru report. So dear friends, discussion of report. When Nehru report was discussed, Muslim League rejected Nehru report. It did not accept Nehru report because in Nehru report, all demands of Muslims of India and Muslim League were rejected by Nehru report. That's why Muslim League rejected it. Jamiat-e-Ulama-e-Hind and other Muslims which were connected with Congress. Jamiat-e-Ulama-e-Hind and Muslims connected with Congress, they both accepted the Nehru report. So dear friends, Nehru report was discussed on 12th March 1929. Civil disobedience movement was started by Congress under the leadership of Gandhi to acceptance of Nehru report in the future constitution of India. It was started in 13th March 1930 by the leadership of Gandhi. So dear friends, civil disobedience movement was launched by Congress under the leadership of Gandhi on 13th March 1930 to accept Nehru report for the future constitution by a British government in India. So dear friends, participants, parties, those parties who took part in all parties conference, which were All India Muslim League, Hindu Mahasabha, Central Sikh League, National Liberal Federation, All India National Congress and Home Rule League and other political parties also participated in all parties conferences. In this way we discuss Nehru report and its silent features and other topics related with Nehru report. So dear friends, in last Nehru report was published on 15 August 1928. So dear friends, in reply of the Nehru report, in reply to the Nehru report, Muslim League under the leadership of Jinnah introduced 14 points of Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. We will discuss in my next lecture. Thank you. Take care. Allah Hafiz.